Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In the last video, we discussed about CSS text. On that, we learned text color, text alignment, text decoration, text transformation, text indentation, letter spacing, text direction, word spacing, text shadow. So we learned these things in a practical. So today we are making in a single single file. We need to complete all the tasks. Okay, so why? Because it is that much of helpful things will be done in a single place. Okay, so now CSS text. So here we need to apply styles. Okay, now here we need to implement. First one is the color. So in the body we apply the color is equal to blue. Okay, similarly I am also taking one more, that is h1, the color is green. Okay, now simply I am using paragraph tag and type welcome to paragraph. Welcome to CSS text. Okay, so this is the first text we are making it, and followed by in the h1 welcome. Okay, so this will come blue color and this h1 will come green color. Once we go through it, all the corrections are happened in this file itself. Why? Because we make it in a single file to give more results. So in this CSS text, just it will open few minutes to take. So yes, right. So this is blue and this is green, will be reflected automatically. That is the way we are representing using font color. So here we are changing the text color of the document, not the background colors. Already we discussed background colors. Now the alignment will come into the picture. Okay, here we are creating a div. In the div, what I am doing is we need to know the border. So we are putting border as 1px. Okay, solid black. Okay, so the next one is padding. We are giving spacing, that is the 10px, and the next is width. We are giving some specific width, that is 200px, and we are also giving height, that is 100px of text. Why? Because when we are applying alignments, automatically we need to know exactly how we are adjusting it. So here text align justify. Okay, so now we are typing this paragraph tag welcome to CSS text color text alignment. Okay, now we need to save it. This will not be, we are creating a div. So here we apply a div, the class is equal to, okay, not required here, whenever necessary I will tell you definitely. So here we need to type the text, this is sample text in div. Okay, same thing will be repeated again. Why? Because if you take more, then we know exactly how it differs. Okay, now I am saving it, now I am calling it. So this is what exactly. So I will take a few more lines so that absolutely it takes left and right indent properly. That is the meaning of. So now what I am doing is I need to apply h1 green and text align center. Okay, similarly I will take h2 and the text align left, next again h3 and text align right. Okay, so already h1 we are using it, we need to use h2 as well as the h3. Here what we need to do, welcome h1, here welcome h2, welcome h3. Okay, after that we need to know the reaction. This is center, this is left, and this is right. So exactly it works, the alignments. Now we go to next one, text decoration. So here also what I am doing is we need to apply the center and I need to apply a text decoration overline. Okay, so similarly h2, the text decoration line through. Okay, similarly in the h3 I need to apply text decoration as underline. Okay, so after saving it we need to execute the line. So here the overline, this is strike through and this is underline. How the things are changing, please keep on observe it. Okay, and the next is we need to apply text transformation. So in the text transformation what I am doing is, so we need to take p dot class upper. So in this what I am doing is text transfer uppercase. Okay, p dot lower. So here the text transformation is lowercase. Okay, so similarly p dot capitalize so here our text transformation capitalize. So what I am doing is here the class attribute is upper. So few text is capital and few text is small. So that helps us in better. So we are making so the class is lower. Welcome to CSS text. Okay, so similarly we are also taking one more, that is capitalize. So welcome to CSS text. Now I saved this text, saved this file, and when I am running it, say see all are upper, all are small, and first letter is capital. It reflects the action what we are doing it. Okay, now what we are doing is actually text indent. So instead of applying for paragraph, I will apply to div. So text indent 50px, obviously the box will be giving 50px indent. Okay, so this is what exactly. So the now is letter spacing. I apply to, we have three paragraphs, so the three paragraphs will change you in a better. Otherwise we need to apply to h1. So the letter spacing 3px. Okay, similarly for h2 letter spacing minus 3px. So that see the text is mixed and here the text little bit free. Okay, when compared to remaining ones. So that is the way letter spacing will be worked. Similarly, line height. Okay, so here we are taking already, we need to take few more p tags, p clauses, p small. So here I need to mention line height 0.7px, p dot big, line height 1.8px. okay, so here what we are doing is we need to take two p tags. Okay, so class attribute is equal to small, welcome to CSS text. So similarly again we need to take one more p tag. The class is big, welcome to CSS text. So after running it, we need to find these two are the meanings. So that is how we are giving it. So finally we need to go for text direction. So the direction already we have one div. Okay, so I will make it the div dot ex1. Okay, in this direction rtl. okay, now what I am doing is same div will be duplicated and I need to apply the cast reaction. Okay, so So here I need to apply the class attribute is ex1. See, the intent is applied here. Okay, the text is from reversing direction. Okay, so I think you understand the text direction is reverse. Okay, next one is word spacing. So what I am doing is h1 and h2 will be changed. Word spacing 10px and h2 word spacing minus 5px. At the same time I need to remove letter spacing in the both the tags. Why? Because otherwise you will get confusion how we are differentiating it. Okay, so that's why I am removing it, and now I am applying it automatically. You can see the difference. Is it right? So finally, one of the interesting thing is shadowing. Okay, now I am applying shadowing to I remove the things what we applied all to h1, so that it can be easy to understand right now. Okay, so we applying shadowing mechanism. So in h1, text shadow, here I need to apply 2px. 2px means vertical shadow and horizontal shadow followed by the color. Okay, similarly text shadow next style is 2px and 2px and 4px slash all are zeros. So in the h3, the text shadow 2px 2px 8px slash FF 4 zeros. Okay, after saving it, we need to use it, see the shadowing how it uses. Okay, thank you.